In this video, I will be discussing the history of the Redondo Beach branch of the Santa Fe Railway. This will be the first in a series of videos discussing local railroads in my area. Beginning in 1885, the Santa Fe incorporated a number of railroads to build lines around Southern California, specifically Greater Los Angeles and San Diego. Two of these railroads we will be focusing on for this video. First is the Los Angeles and Santa Monica Railway of 1886 and the Redondo Beach Railway of 1888. The Los Angeles and Santa Monica Railway was chartered to build from a point south of Los Angeles in what is now Vernon at Redondo Junction to Port Bologna. Port Bologna was a planned port for shipping cargo in and out of. The line was built by way of Inglewood to what is now Playa del Rey. Work on the port began in January of 1887 and proved to be a failure by 1889 due to the marshland conditions of the area. But in 1887, just as work was underway at the port, the Redondo Beach Railway was being built. It was built from Inglewood through what is now El Segundo, Manhattan Beach, Hermosa Beach, all the way down to Redondo Beach. Interestingly enough, the railway opened before it was incorporated in 1888. Now back to the Central California Railway. All of the lines that it controlled were merged under the Central California Railway name, which was a subsidiary of the Santa Fe Railway. In 1889, the Central California and the California Southern merged to form the Southern California Railway, which was, again, a Atchison, Topeka, and Santa Fe Railway subsidiary. By 1906, the company was completely absorbed into the Santa Fe system. After the Redondo Beach Railway was built, the town of Redondo Beach started to grow. At first, it was more of a freight harbor destination, but because of the passenger service offered by the Santa Fe, as well as later the Pacific Electric Railway, it became more of a resort town. Shortly after the completion of the Redondo Beach Railway, in the 1890s, things started to pop up, the most notable of which include the plunge and, more importantly, was the 225-room hotel, the Hotel Redondo. That was built in 1890. There was also a boardwalk at Redondo Beach, not the modern one you're thinking of today. And as far as the freight goes, the facilities at Redondo Beach included three wharves for transferring freight and even passengers from ships to the trains. At first, these were dual gauge because of the narrow gauge Redondo Railway, which again is another video. And there were even electric lines for the electric locomotives because freight was also hauled in that line. Some of the industries on the branch included a Standard Oil facility, two power plants, a military installation that was made during World War II, Metlock's Pottery, and the Abel and Dougherty Cement Company. Much of the early traffic of the line was wood and lumber. Los Angeles was growing. Much of the wood that Los Angeles needed was being shipped through the ports of Redondo Beach, Santa Monica, San Pedro / Long Beach, and even Newport Beach. In 1902, the electric trolley came to Redondo Beach. This meant bad news for the Santa Fe Railway. The electric trolleys outperformed the Santa Fe steam service, and by 1918, the last passenger train to Redondo Beach occurred. The freight service, however, continued on for a number of years afterwards. By 1920, most of the traffic from the harbor had been moved to San Pedro and Long Beach harbors. The last wharf was dismantled in 1926. The Hotel Redondo was demolished in 1925, and most of the plunges and bathhouses and a lot of the boardwalk was gone. Because of the industries that were still along the line, it kept going for a few decades afterwards. The power of the railway usually consisted of smaller locomotives. During the early years, 440s and 460s were generally the standard power on the Redondo Beach branch. The 282s of the 3100 to 3287 series became regular power on the branch line. In the diesel era, there was a variety of equipment ranging from GP7s, Alco S2s, to the Santa Fe's own CF7s. The exception to this is the railfan excursions held on the branch in the 1940s and 1950s. One of these excursions featured 484 number 3758, and another excursion featured a set of F7 streamlined units. As with many railroads during the 1960s and 1970s, traffic on the branch line started to decline sharply. On September 11th, 1979, the last train to Redondo Beach occurred. This was done by CF7 number 2538 with a single flat car and caboose number 999178. After the line was officially abandoned in 1983, the right-of-way was sold to the cities of Manhattan Beach and Hermosa Beach, and today forms the Greenbelt Parkway. Now, if you're wondering what happened to the branch line and what it looks like today, you're not alone. I wondered this myself. So I decided to go out and find some of the locations where the railway operated, as well as some of the industries that the railway served. Here are some clips that I took on my jaunt out to Manhattan Beach, Redondo Beach, Hermosa Beach, and the beginning of the branch line at El Segundo. Now, the first stop on our jaunt down the current state of Santa Fe's Redondo branch is Wise Junction, or Wise Crossing. This junction is of the Harbor Subdivision, which goes off to the left side of the screen, and the current Union Pacific El Segundo branch to the right side of the screen. Now, the next stop on our little tour is the end of track of where the Redondo branch used to be. The lead to the refinery is off to the left side, and what you see now in the foreground is the current Redondo Beach branch line, what used to be the branch line. There are still ties in place and part of the rail. There are a few bits and pieces just laying around for no particular reason. Not too far from that location, it starts to look a lot nicer. This is the Greenbelt Valley, or the Greenbelt, as it's sometimes called, also known as the Veterans Parkway. This is currently in Manhattan Beach, where I took this video. Right around this area, there was a spur line that went from the Redondo branch, which is about here, and went across the street into the neighborhood this way. Now, this innocuous little neighborhood used to be the location of the military battery created by the Harbor Defense Railway. Now, there is some evidence of railroad ties, such as these stairs in someone's property. And this is the area where Metlock's Pottery used to be. That's where the old branch was, and then the spur track would have ended about here, and the building for pottery would be there. Now we're at Pier Avenue in Hermosa Beach. You can still see exactly where the railway went, right where all these wood chips are. So, there are a few things that were here. First, the public library, and behind it too, that's where Abel and Daugherty Cement Company was. And then over here, a long time before that, was the, what is it called? Los Angeles Lumber Company, or Lumber and Box Company. And then here is the Hermosa Depot. I'd be on the back side of the station. When Redondo Beach was abandoned,
the freight operations for the branch moved to Hermosa Beach Station. And this is the south end of the Greenbelt or Veterans Parkway. One of the two. And this is the end of Hermosa Beach, and on the other side of the street is Redondo Beach. There's the power plant, and the tracks went right along here, thereabout, and through what is now this mini storage place. The power plant is back there. There's the self-storage where the right-of-way was. And down in that direction, spurs split off, went down this street, right about where I'm standing, through here to what was Ganal Lumber Company. Now it's the postal annex. And down that way, near Broadway, was an ice house. I'm guessing the ice house was for packing fish. So the railway, the main line for the branch, came on the other side of this building along Pacific. And right about here, there were some more spurs for lumber and various services that the railway provided. It continued down in that direction towards downtown Long Beach, but right around here was the old turntable, and the station for the Santa Fe was right about in the center of the camera near Pacific on the other side of this block. This is where the Pacific Light and Power Company power plant was. And now down at Redondo Beach Pier. This is near Veterans Park. And Pier 1, or the Wharf Number 1, went about where the current Redondo Beach Pier is now. The second wharf is about straight ahead of me is where it used to be. And then right about where the jetty is, Topaz Jetty, is where the third wharf was. Now behind me at Veterans Park used to be where the Hotel Redondo was. 255 room wooden structure, built in 1890 and demolished in 1925. And this is where the last remaining section of track is in Redondo Beach. This is the last remaining section of any railroad in Redondo Beach.
Thank you for watching this video. If you're wondering where to find some of these locations that I visited, or any other information regarding locations on the railway, I have made a map using Google My Maps, and that will be linked down in the description below. And please, stay old school on the vintage rails, and until next time, God bless.